Good morning, students. Today I am going to talk about the numericals which we are going to use in nuclear energy and few questions which are there in sources of energy. So let us start with the numericals first. So the first numerical is based on Einstein's equation that E is equal to mc square, where E stands for the energy, which usually is taken in joules in SI system. M stands for the mass taken in kilogram in SI system. And C stands for the speed of light, which is taken to be 3×10⁸ meter per second in SI system. So here is the question that what is the energy equivalent to 1 kilogram of matter? Mass is given to you, 1 kilogram of matter. You need to find out the energy which is equivalent to 1 kilogram of matter. Hence, according to the formula, E is equal to mc square. You need to find out energy. Mass is given to you. C, the value of C is already known to you. That is 3×10⁸. So put here m is equal to 1 kilogram. C is equal to 3×10⁸ meter per second. Put these two values in the equation E equal to mc square and you will get the answer that total energy using mass equal to 1 kilogram and velocity equal to 3×10⁸, the energy will be equal to 9×10�16 joules. Now students, next numerical is the atomic bomb that exploded over Hiroshima releases 67 trillion joules of energy. That means 6.7×10⁰⁹ joules of energy. How much mass was converted to energy in this explosion? So you need to find out that the mass which is being converted into energy. You know that in equation, your left hand side of the reactants must be equal to the total mass of the right hand side. If these masses are not equal, that means there is some mass which is changing from mass to energy. The change in mass is converting into energy. So E equal to mc square. This is the formula which we are going to use. Energy is given to you 6.7×10⁰ joule. Velocity, you know that is equal to 3×10⁸ meter per second. Now just put these values in the above equation, E is equal to mc square, and get the value of mass from here. So E is 6.7×10⁰, mass you have to find out, C is 3×10⁸, and whole square of it. Now solve this. Now 3×10⁸ whole square is 9×10⁰. Get the value of mass by dividing this equation by 9×10⁰. So 6.7×10⁰ is divided by 9×10⁰. Cancel out the terms and get the answer for it. You will be getting 7.44×10⁻⁴ kilogram. Now convert kilograms into gram. Now you can see that only 0.744 grams of mass is being converted into this much, 6.7×10⁰⁹ joules of energy. So this is a huge amount of energy, and mass given to you which is being used here is only 0.744 grams. Now question number 3, or example number 3, is 48 kilojoule of energy is produced per minute in a nuclear reactor. Calculate number of fissions which would be taking place in the reactor per second. In 1 second, how many fissions are taking place, how many number of fissions are taking place, that we need to calculate. If the energy released per fission is 3.2×10⁻¹ joules. So given to you is that this is the energy which is used, which is released per fission. So let us start with the given things first. Given thing is that the energy produced per minute is 48 kilojoules. So write down that thing. The total energy produced per minute is 48 kilojoules, which will be equal to 48×10⁹ joules. So kilo is being converted into 10 to the power 3. Now the second information given to us is that energy released per fission. In one fission, the energy released is, that is equal to 3.2 into 10 to the power minus 11 joules. Now per fission this much energy is released, but what we need to calculate is that calculate the number of fission which would be taking place in the reactor per second. So wherever there is minute, the time has to be converted into second. Here you have total energy produced per minute, so please convert this total energy produced per second. In 60 seconds, then in 1 second, so you will be getting energy produced per second is equal to 48 into 10 to the power 3 divided by 60. So this quantity will give you energy produced per second, which is equal to this. Now how many number of fissions are taking place in 1 second? That will be equal to the energy produced per second whole divided by the energy released per fission. Calculate them and you will be getting the answer. Example number 4. If 200 million electron volt energy is released in the fission of a single uranium-235 nucleus, the number of fission required per second to produce 1 kilowatt power shall be A, B, C or D. Given to you is that 1 electron volt is equal to 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 joule. Where we are going to use this part, here it is given to you 200 million electron volt. So you need to convert this energy into joules because we have to use the SI units. So let us start with the given values first, then we will be calculating that the number of fissions required per second. So first, the given thing to us is the fission of single uranium nucleus releases 200 million electron volt of energy. So energy released is how much? 200 million electron volt. Million is 10 to the power 6. 1 electron volt value is given to us, that is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Put these value and simplify them. 200 million is 10 to the power 6. Electron volt is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19. Now calculate it and you will get the value 3.2 into 10 to the power minus 11 joules. Now students, what you have to find is number of fission required per second. Number of fission required per second. That means you need to find out here number of fission required per second. Given to you is that the energy released is this much, and also it is given to us is that this energy produced is equal to 1 kilowatt power. So power is given to you. We need to relate this power with the energy. We know that power is equal to energy divided by time. So energy is E, but this is the energy for one fission. There were number of fissions which are taking place, so total energy of number of fissions, so N into E, number of fissions divided by time is power. Power is energy divided by time, that is NE divided by time. Now what is asked to you is to find out number of fission per second, that means number of fission per time you have to find out. So from this equation, N upon T is equal to P upon E. N upon T is equal to P upon E, where P stands for power and E stands for energy. Just put the value. How much is the power given to you? 1 kilowatt. So put the value 1 kilowatt. You also have to convert kilowatt into watt. So 1 kilowatt will be equal to 10 to the power 3 watt. Put the value of power, that is equal to 10 to the power 3 watt. Energy you just now have calculated in joules, that is 3.2 into 10 to the power minus 11. Put that value also, divide them and get the answer for it. So you will be getting here number of fission per second is equal to 3.125 into 10 to the power 13, which is option A. Hence, option A is the correct option. Yes, students, this is very important question. Question number 5. The energy produced in the sun is due to fission, fusion, chemical reaction, or motion of electrons and ions. So let us start with the solution. I hope you already have done this chapter of nuclear energy. And in nuclear energy, we also have done what fusion and fission is. So in case of fusion, you know very well that the two lighter nuclei, they fuse together to form a huge nuclei. There we have taken that one deuterium atom of hydrogen reacts with one tritium atom of hydrogen and they give rise to helium under some conditions. So it is known fact that the source of huge solar energy is fusion of lighter nuclei, and fusion of hydrogen nuclei into helium nuclei is continuously taking place in plasma with the continuous liberation of energy. Hence the answer for this is fusion. This year's question paper, that is the question paper given to the students by CBSE board in 2019, there was a question that where is the geothermal energy found in the world? Other than India, you need to find out any country where geothermal energy is found. So some options are given over here, that the largest group of geothermal power plant actually is in California, that is United States. Second country is Indonesia. There are Southern East Asian nations also, but name is not given here. Turkey is one of the country, New Zealand, Mexico, Italy, Kenya, and Philippines and Costa Rica Island are also in the row which produces geothermal energy. Many time through boards, this question is asked that what is charcoal? How is charcoal obtained from wood? And why is charcoal considered to be the best option or better fuel than wood? So charcoal actually is obtained when wood is heated in the absence of air. This process is known as destructive distillation of wood. Charcoal is considered better fuel than wood because it has higher calorific value and also it does not produce any smoke on burning. So with this, we have ended the chapter. We have completed the chapter of sources of energy. Questions will be given to you later, which you have to complete in your FAIR notebook. Thank you, students.